Good morning, good afternoon. Welcome to this first video related to microbiome products. My name is Marielle Fournier. I am Senior Director at VCLS in charge of microbiome related products development strategy and registration. I am pleased today to provide you with some key considerations related to the development and registration of these microbiome products as either drugs or foods. As you know, the microbiome is composed of bacteria, yeast, fungi, and virus inhabiting a specific environment. In human, it relates to the gastrointestinal flora, but also flora in the skin, in the lungs and genitals. We have now strong evidence of a close relationship between the state of a microbiome and the development of some diseases. Current therapeutic developments are focusing on the gastrointestinal disease, but also obesity in weight control and other diseases in neurology, such as Alzheimer's disease and depression, but also in oncology area. So now, new products are therefore developed under either the drug or the food regulatory pathways. The first fundamental difference is on the regulatory definitions. Considering the European definitions, a medicinal product is a substance or combination of substances presented as having properties for treating or preventing disease, or that may be used or administered either with a view of restoring, correcting, or modifying physiological functions or to making medical diagnoses. A food product can be any substance or product intended to be ingested by humans, and it includes any substance intentionally incorporated in the food during manufacture, preparation or treatment. But the food substance may be qualified as novel or new if never used before, and food cannot claim or imply that this food can treat, prevent or cure any disease or medical condition. However, it can claim a reduction of a disease risk factor. Other factors to be considered are the presentation of a product, the composition, the health claims and associated modes of action, as well as the route of administration and the targeted population. The regulatory pathway considerations are basically for foods a simple regulatory pathway with some simple notification, once of course applications for health claims and all novel food are approved, and requirements related to a facility according ISO 22000 standard for GMP for food. But also some constraints to take into account, such as a possible significant amount of data to be required related either to the substance characterization or the health claim evidence, and at the end, limited claims and exclusivity for the market. For medicinal product, we have a more complex regulatory pathway leading to a complex, long and costly development required with some extensive data set to be provided at the time of application, expertise and demonstration of the benefit-risk ratio, as well as a huge pharmacovigilance requirements. We have also requirements in terms of facility with good manufacturing practice for medicinal products and associated inspections. However, we can have access to significant advantages in some specific conditions, such as accelerated pathways, scientific advice and various interactions with authorities, or sometimes financial incentives. And of course, we will have specific indications and data and market exclusivity. As a conclusion, close relationship between microbiome and disease is more and more described and leads to the development of new drugs and new foods. Differences in regulatory paths and associated challenges are based on the product characteristics, the claims, and targeted population. These have to be taken into consideration to optimize the development together with the related cost and timelines. Details on these two pathways will be discussed in subsequent videos to come next. Thank you.